Hey everybody, today we are reacting to Either Or by Elliott Smith. Now recently I put up a poll on my channel and I asked y'all which album you wanted me to react to out of these five, and Either Or came out on top. Just because Either Or came out on top does not mean I'm gonna skip out on stuff like To Be Kind. I will get around to all of it. I'm just gonna kinda go with the flow and we'll see how fast I can get these videos out. Now, when it comes to Elliott Smith's stuff so far, I like Roman Candle, and I like the self-titled album. Nothing has completely floored me yet. Like, I definitely enjoy both of those records a lot, but it's nothing that, like, It's really good, though. It's just solid music, solid passionate music and songwriting, and especially lyrics as well. But this one's, according to a lot of people, seems to be the big one, you know, the one that everyone loves. So I'm interested to see how I feel about it. So let's just give it a shot. The first song is called Speed Trials. I already like it. For some reason why, but the sound of, like, just the production or where this was recorded already kind of jives with me a little bit better. I don't know why. I don't have an explanation for that. And maybe I will towards the end of the album, but I just like this, the kind of warm sort of space that the production gives off. I thought that was a sweet opener. I just think it's a nice way to ease you into the album. It seems like that's what a lot of Elliott Smith's openers do. They kind of just ease you into the sound of what's going to happen. Lyrically, this is pretty interesting, as Elliott Smith always is. I'm just a brief smile crossing your face. I'm running speed trials, standing in place. I think that's a really cool phrase right there. You're such a pinball, yeah, you know it's true. There's always something you go back running to follow the path of no resistance. Seems like maybe it's about someone that can't really keep their life together. That's kind of what I'm gathering, but I think that's pretty cool. But yeah, solid opener. I don't really have any problems with that. I think it was good. Next one is Alameda. Okay, real quick, I'm gonna pause. I don't really do this normally, but I just want to mention his vocal timbre on this album is the best I think it's ever been. There's something about it that just really grabs me, and I think it's just the best vocally his timbre has sat in his career thus far. And I just love that warm production. I do think the snare is a little weird, but we'll see what happens. I might get used to it. That was another good one. I like that more than the first one. it just had a bigger sound. It had a lot more going on. You could hear there was an organ in there, which I've never heard Elliott use. At least I don't think. I will say that I think the snare was a little weird. I kind of stuck out a little bit as not being the best, but I mean, I get that it's supposed to be a lo-fi sound sort of thing. Not really lo-fi, but just sort of raw. Still, that didn't really plague my enjoyment of the song that much. It was still a very nice song. I think lyrically, it's also talking about kind of someone who can't really be fixed or doesn't have much to offer to friends and stuff like that. Nobody broke your heart. You broke your own because you can't finish what you start. Harsh. But yeah, another good one. I'm kind of interested to see if it sticks with this sort of feeling or if it does something a little different. I have a feeling it's going to stick with this overall feeling, which I enjoy, but I'm hoping I can get that extra step up. Ballad of Big Nothing is next. That was good. I like that. Definitely a lot more up-tempo, kind of, and just a little bit more energetic in a way. I like the background vocals at the very, very end. I thought that added a lot. I think that this one is talking about kind of someone that can kind of just do whatever they want. And yeah, no one's going to stop you, but no one's going to try to stop you either, you know? I'll spit and spite, you're up all night and down every day, a tired man with only hours to go, just waiting to be taken away, getting into the back of a car for candy from some stranger, watching the parade with pinpoint eyes full of smoldering anger. See, just bars. Elliott Smith has some just great lyricism. I think that's the thing I honestly appreciate about Elliott Smith the most, which is kind of surprising, but he just has such interesting stories to tell with every song. Next up is Between the Bars, and it seems like it's his most popular song ever, so I'm very curious to see what this is.
Drink up, baby, stay up all night with the things you could do.
For some reason, and I'm not just saying this because it's the most popular one, but it just literally what I felt. For some reason, it hit me a little bit harder than some of his other acoustic songs like this. There's something about it that kind of brings a little bit of a haunting feeling. I don't know. It's a little haunting to me. Elliott always has had a darker tone with his music and just his lyrics in general, and this, I think, very much proves that point. Wow. Reading the lyrics, like, man, it seems like this one's about how alcohol can kind of take your life and, you know, change you from a good to a bad person, or just kind of, you lose a little bit of yourself with the abuse of alcohol. It also talks about someone else here in the picture. Again, with this song specifically, it kind of surprises me that it's his biggest song. Because it's, I don't know, it just kind of caught me off guard a little bit. Still a great song. Not my favorite Elliott Smith song ever, but it's a very solid song because of its lyrical portrayal and how much it focuses you in on this like one space and what he's saying. It's very, it feels like it just wants you to pay attention to those lyrics. But yeah, it's still a very solid song. I liked it. Pictures of Me is the next one. Isn't that a song by The Cure? Pictures of... Fuck, hold on, I need to look this up. Pictures of You is The Cure song, yeah.
Start, stop, and start. Stupid acting smart. Flirting with the flicks. You say it's just for kids.
That was 100% easily my favorite so far. Loved that. When those drums came in, oh, that hit hard. That hit really hard. But yeah, geez. That just, like, that's what I want from Elliott Smith. Just something that felt a little bit more creative, too. It felt like he was implementing a lot more just styles or different things into that song and just felt more full. Seems like maybe this one is about how people misinterpret his actions or how he acts, or just getting popular and realizing that it's not what it seems to be. Everybody's dying just to get the disease, meaning popularity can be a little bit more hellish than certain things, because people view you differently, people, you know, think of you or have their own opinions about every single thing you do, you know. I think that's an interesting song topic. But yeah, easy favorite so far. I just love that. I love pretty much everything it did. Hey, look here, we're back on the no-name train. I remember this from Roman Candle. It already gives me Roman Candle vibes. That went from, like, kind of pretty decent, you know, to very good. Because, again, that was nice, the guitar, and I liked it, and it's, you know, it's chill, but it's just, like, that extra step is what makes me like and come back to Elliott Smith's music more. This had that extra step, you know, when the drums came in and it started driving the song a little more. And drums aren't the only thing that I think a song needs just to elevate it. Like, he could have added a bunch of guitars or more, like, of an ambience to the song or whatever, but I think it did work very well with the drums coming in there. Lyrically, it kind of seems like this guy just kind of fucked up his life, you know? Yeah. I don't know if it's talking about himself or if it's he's acting as a protagonist, but I'm sure it relates to his life in some way. But yeah, it definitely grew on me as it kept going. This one is Rose Parade. Ask me to come down and watch the parade. This feels like walking through a forest of fall trees while it's really nice outside. That's what it sounds like. Tripped over a dog. I think that might, maybe, it might be my my least favorite so far. I like some of the stuff it did, but it felt a little bit more one note than the other songs. Again, still not bad at all. There's a lot of, like, playful lyrical lines in this song. The trumpeter's obviously been drinking, because he's fucking up even the simplest lines. Like, that's kind of funny. But yeah, it's pretty good. Punch and Judy, alright. Smooth vibe. The bass. Nice. I actually really like this. It's super smooth. Definitely liked that one more. It didn't do anything too crazy, but it just felt a little bit more consistent and melodically memorable than the last one, just to me. It was just catchy. It had a good melody. Just sitting here closing my eyes, just kind of like, you know, bobbing to it. It's just, it's a nice feeling, something you can kind of relax to. I also like kind of the contradicting tone as well, because it's a super smooth, like, chill song, but then lyrically you have him, I believe, talking about someone who just continues to make mistakes and doesn't learn from it. Yeah, there was just something about that one that kind of just clicked with me. It just was a really chill vibe, nice feeling. Yeah. Next up, we got Angelos. Ooh. That's some impressive guitar.
Someone's always coming around here, trailing someone to kill. With real skill, so glad to meet you, Angelos. Don't start me trying now.
That was some good shit. Just, I really liked whatever was going on there in the back. I don't know, it added a lot though. The guitar work was impressive, definitely. And the melody was very strong, and I liked it a lot. Another chill, pretty simple song, besides the guitar work, but it just had a feeling. This seems to be about like moving to a new location and the challenges that face it, the hope that you try to get from it, and also the dreadful sort of feeling it carries. I could be wrong, I think that's kind of what it's talking about though, and I just, yeah. This whole album's kind of just a vibe. I don't know, it's not, again, it's nothing crazy. And I feel like Elliott Smith is never really anything that's just earth-shattering, but it's just nice music. It's just solid, good songs, you know? Cupid's Trick is next. She's shaking down, darker sort of guitar line there. That's like the most energetic he's ever gotten, like hands down, I think, up at least up till this point. That was good. God, it just caught me off guard because I didn't expect him to go that direction, really. It just, because again, it was good in the beginning and then it built up a little more and then just the distortion came on and I'm like, whoa, very, very cool sound. The lyrics are interesting too. She's shaking down, I'm absent and numb from shock, reaching around for the hands of the clock. Cupid's trick comes down to shake and deal, a stupid kick that makes me reel. Kind of an angry sort of thing, maybe? Felt a little more rebellious. But yeah, solid ass track. 2:45 a.m. Now we back to the chill stuff. After that. Going out sleepwalking, where mute memories start talking. Mute memories. It's a cool phrase there. The boss that couldn't help with hidden cracks that don't show, but they constantly just grow. Recollection you have erased. High drums. It's an interesting choice to me how he added the drums there, like right at the last second at the end. I think it was cool and very unexpected, but it just didn't last long. Still, I actually really enjoyed that one. I really liked kind of the walking guitar line in between the chords, you know, the full-on chords that he was strumming. I like the melody. Going out sleepwalking where mute memories start talking. The boss that couldn't help but hurt you and the pretty thing you made desert you. So many interesting lyrical ideas here, and it's kind of sounds like he's been beaten down, you know, looking for the man who attacked me while everybody was laughing at me, you know. Another solid one, though. Wow, we're already at the last song. What the... This went by fast, I feel like. Let's get to the final song here. It's called Say Yes. I'm in love with the world through the eyes of a girl who's still around the morning after. Wow. loved that. For some reason, that one just hit me a little bit harder. It felt very conclusive to the album, but also just lyrically a little bit more potent. I don't know. The melody was strong. I really like how he goes up. Da, da, da. I like that. I really like the stray guitar outside of the acoustic one that was kind of adding in some lead lines. Very, very nice. Made the song so much better just on that alone. I don't know. I genuinely really like that one. I think that's one I just connect with a little more, and one that I think fits the album's closer spot and does a great job at exiting you out, but also giving you a really solid song. But yeah, that was Either Or. Wow. Again, as I said, I feel like it went by kind of fast, but I don't know. This is, in a way, kind of what I expected from this album. Did that make it any worse that it was what I expected? No. I was expecting it to be good, and I was expecting it to be a step up from the other two albums, and it was. I think it genuinely was. But I was hoping with Here, he would up the sound a little bit more, and I think this album is very consistent within its sound. It has a feeling that kind of brings you through the whole album. The lyrics are on freaking point. I just, as always, really, with Elliott Smith. I think the songs are more engaging here. I think they're more unique. And I think this is the best vocally from Elliott Smith that we've gotten so far. There's something about his voice on this album that does something more to me than the previous two. Nothing was bad on this album, really. I mean, maybe there was one or two songs where I was like, you know, there's better. But overall, this is a very solid track list, and it kind of just gives you a very nice, warm slice of what Elliott Smith is about. I think this is one I'm going to be coming back to quite a bit more than the first two, because, again, I genuinely did like those first two, but as I said, it's just, there's something about this one that kind of drags me in a little bit more as a full album. It's not too long, it doesn't overstay its welcome, and I think that it doesn't need to, it just has a very solid track list. I think right now my favorite is Pictures of Me. That one was just awesome. Cupid's Trick also completely caught me off guard because I did not expect him to go in that direction. And Say Yes was also a very, very good song. And I have more favorites, but those are my, like, tops. But yeah, I'll give more final thoughts here. But yeah, right now, I mean, I'm kind of in a chill mood today. That maybe that's why this worked for me. I mean, maybe y'all can tell, but I'm just kind of in a chill mood, and this kind of just added to my day in that sort of way. I don't know. I really liked it. See how I feel in the future, but yes, very solid album. Okay, so I still pretty much completely agree with everything I said in the video. I just think it's his best album. I don't know. The favorites that I have and the ones that I mentioned in the video are still my favorites. I think 2:45 AM grew off me a little bit. Just re-listening to it. Between the Bars is still really solid, and Alameda is pretty good too. I could keep going, but I mean, I'm just gonna keep it short and sweet and say that, yeah, I still pretty much agree, and I still think that this is his best album so far. I'm feeling about an 8.5 out of 10 on this one. Thank you so much for watching. As I said, I've been busy, and this one did take a while to get out, but at least I'm getting it out. I don't know what my uploading schedule will be, but I think during the summer, when I'm getting closer to the summer, it'll be a little bit more frequent. But yeah, thank you again, and I'll see you later.